Hey everyone, Scorch2 here. Welcome back to Zork Grand Inquisitor. So if you're just joining us now, you may remember, actually you won't remember. If you're joining us, you didn't know. In the last part, we just got into Hades. We passed the test to get into Hades. We had to dial the stupid customer service number and solve their weird-ass puzzle. And we paid Charon to take us across the River Styx, and we got through the gate by impersonating him so that the two-headed beast would allow us by. And if you're familiar with this game or saw the last part, we found ourselves a totem on the ground over here, so we picked that up. That was our buddy Brog. And there's a time tunnel here, and since we now have the ability to open the time tunnels, which I did on the last part, we can use the Yastard spell to send one of our totemized friends through the time tunnel. And then there's items to be picked up. So this is part of how we're solving the overall puzzle objective of the game. So I'm going to go ahead and we're going to use Yastard on our friend the dragon here. So we pop out.
Oh, what an attractive little archipelago. This is my idea of a vacation, a little fun, a little sun, and I don't have any.
Alright, so we notice ourselves.
Hey, can we get a few drinks around here?
I'm gonna be making kind of weird comments here and there. We notice ourselves in
an
area that's completely.
The kind with the little umbrellas?
Shut up, guy. Out in the middle of the water, it's a little mini puzzle, kinda. Turns out that you send the wrong character to these areas through the time tunnels, you can just go back through and send the right one through. Each character has a specific set of abilities that allow them to do whatever they have to do. So in this one, there's one of the magical items is here, and we're gonna have to solve the set of puzzles in order to get that. So I'm gonna go ahead and we're gonna fly because we have dragon power. So you'll have to excuse the screw-ups on the cutscenes. But basically, we're only allowed to fly to a certain amount of places because of the amount of the, if you haven't figured it out, this is a giant dragon in the water, amount of the body that's exposed. So in order to get him to move, you have to twitch his toenails and his claws. So you can see now the belly is out. Go belly. Some items to pick up. These are inflatables. And then we have another spot here. There's a skeleton holding
well,
a
that's
tire
an air pump.
Pump.
So let's pump some air.
Let's do it. So if we fly to the next area, which is his head. Turn around. See, his nostrils are exposed. And since we're very strapped for things we can do, let's try putting stuff in there. Like so. So doing that causes, and it's kind of subtle, very hard to notice, causes things causes his foot, the other foot, to come out of the water. I think. Oh, you know what you have to do? You have to go to the. You have to go back to this foot. You twitch the toenail again. Actually, you know what? I don't even have to do that. I'm completely drawing a blank. That made his belly go back in. We shouldn't have done that. Turns out, we had all the items we needed, and I drew a blank. What we gotta do is once you get the tire pump from the skeleton and the two inflatables, you have everything you need in order to get this guy to do what we want. You take the tire pump, you can inflate each of these items.
Oh, dear God, it's a dragon.
Let's go ahead and save. We can't... You can die here, but only if you do the events in the wrong way.
Hello? Hello? What's going on up there?
You might want to just be quiet, fool. Oh, the coconut
that
of Gwendor.
That would be a coconut. Oh, yeah. The coconut of Gwendor. I was looking for that nut.
Let's go ahead and grab it. And then we'll show what happens. Let me save first. Again. We'll show what happens if you just try to take the coconut.
Actually, since you're there, maybe you could help me out. I'm trying to make myself a pina colada down here, and I'm running short on ingredients. So I need to run to the store to pick up a coconut. If I throw you a rope, could you tie it to one of the dragon's teeth so I could climb up?
Yeah, sure, buddy.
That's a rope, all right. Thanks, mate.
Let's go back. And then I'll save again because I don't want to listen to that guy talk when I restore. So what we'll do is if you just
Hello,
try
there.
To leave...
Hello?
Well, I'm not going to dwell on it, but that was stupid.
Hello?
If you just try to leave, it doesn't kill you, but you can't just go.
I'm not going to dwell on it, but that was stupid.
So, what we're going to do here is we need to get this coconut out of here. And if you look up at the spots where we put these items, you can see that we can interact with some stuff. And this thing in particular is facing that way for a reason.
Hello, anybody? I don't mean to be a bother, but my ice is starting to melt.
No one cares. Shut up, you. You can put
the
coconut
convenient.
In there.
We could put something there.
But now we need a way to get it out of there without getting killed. So what you can do, you'll notice this gold tooth.
Oh, come on! I mean, you gotta be a moron to perform an impromptu root canal on a sleeping dragon. It just isn't done, I mean.
Since we don't have the coconut, we can leave. And if we fly out here, we can use the rope that guy threw us to do something cool by tying these two items together.
Hello there.
Here's what we're gonna do.
Hello?
Shut up.
Did you get the rope?
Go away. We're gonna use this
Hello?
Tooth to pop Mr.
She blows!
That's odd.
Hey, if it blows up, must come down. That's the golden feature.
And that's how we get the coconut out of Dragon's mouth.
Oh, well, that was easy. All we had to do was tickle a freaking dragon, fly into his mouth, send the guy to his doom, and shoot an inflatable sea captain out of his nose. I wish everything in life was so simple.
And he's still sleeping. So we can,
come to Papa, you nut.
Pick up the coconut, and then Mr. Castle just pops out of the water. Let's,
Hey, nice joint. Now let's just, stick this thingamabob in that thingamajigger and tango on out of here, okay? Ta-da! Good work, kid.
Alright. We got ourselves the first magical item. Yay, aren't we proud? Yes. Alright, so now we're back in Hades. Let's go ahead and save. And now, we have to get ourselves out of here. In order to do so, not letting me turn around. Why is it not letting me turn around? What the hell's going on here? Come on. It's being a bitch. Alright, let me try restoring here. Of course. Something is hosed. There we go. Okay.
Let's cut the crap, okay? You got this, Bob. You know the drill. You're the adventurer. I'm your
basic two-headed guardian of Hades-type creature. You're looking for treasure, mana...
We already heard this. Shut up. So, we need to...
Rock, Sammy.
Turn ourselves in.
Well, you look like us, which is an improvement. but you're still not.
Oh, that's an interesting look. Interesting like Jojo the slime-faced boy is interesting.
Yeah. We need to be him in order to get ourselves out of here, because he won't let us through if we're ourselves. Once you're in Hades, you're stuck there. That's kind of how it works. We saw this already, so I'm just going to skip it. So now what we got to do is, if you remember from back when we were exploring in the Dungeon Master's Lair, there was another time tunnel that we uncovered in the bookcase, or the cupboard. So I'm going to go ahead and use the teleporter to go back to the Dungeon Master's Lair. And we'll go ahead and arrow up over here. See, there's Castle. Friendly Castle. Come on through. This one we have not activated. So let's go ahead and activate it. And then send our buddy, Brog through there.
Yes, dude.
The Brog is nice and short. Oh my.
Brog no like it here. Brog teeny bit scared.
So this one is a little bit harder because you can die a couple ways in this area. You will encounter a familiar enemy to the Zork universe.
Board's hurting house. Leave house alone, Nails.
Up the ability for us to go inside the house, because he's awesome, he's strong, he can pull boards off of the house and whatnot. This mailbox here.
Hello, hello up there. Why you never talk to Brog?
Keep this in mind, we'll need to make use of it. So, interesting factoid that'll come up in a little bit here. We need to be able to go in this house, and I'm gonna go ahead and save here. Again, and I'll show you why. So we go in the house, it's dark. And there's Gru down there. And if you try to do anything in here, it makes you die. You were eaten by a Gru. Now, what was going through your head? A pitch black cave in a Zork game, what do you think was gonna happen? You have died. 499 of a possible 1,000. Let's go ahead and restore. Bring it on back here. So, we can't go in the house because we'll die. You may notice there's some torches over here. Let's pick on that one.
I'm the bickering torch. That's what they call me anyways. I prefer to call myself a grande queso.
Cook on them again.
Alright, but I'm warning you. First sign of a Gru and I'm doused, you hear me? Out like a light.
So we can take him with us, but if we go inside the house with that torch, he goes out.
I'm the flickering torch. I do flicker, and that's okay. I'm afraid of dark caves, and I've accepted that about myself. I'm hearing that you really enjoy rocks.
Brog eat rocks.
So, you may notice that, and there's a couple of games
everyone
that I can't
remember.
Everyone
likes the flickering torch better than me.
If you take the bickering torch with the flickering torch, you get an interesting dialogue. But you may notice that in some of the other games I've played, I may have mentioned, I made reference to this game. Where I
you
say, Brog like
sometimes
rocks.
Sometimes a torch is just a freaking torch.
I go, Brog like rocks. I've said it a few times, actually. That's a reference to this game.
Was that a Gru? Is this a dark cave? Did you hear one word I said to you? See him, pal. I'm doused.
We're quite a team, aren't we, you and I? I wouldn't miss this for the world. As long as you're in this dank hole, I'll be burning right beside you every second of the way. Not a flicker in sight, my thick friend. Oh, dear. Oh, dear.
So if you take the bickering torch in here, he pussies out and goes out, and then you die. So you can't do that. You gotta take the flickering torch with you. Then you can go down the stairs into this area. It looks like there's something over there, but we can't do anything about that. So, what we're gonna do is we're gonna feed Brog.
Mmm, creamy quartz filling. Brog favorite flavor. Rocks.
Yeah.
Mmm, creamy quartz filling. Brog favorite flavor.
So,
oh, Brog tummy full. No more rocks today.
You can eat the rocks. It doesn't really do anything, but you feed Brog and that's cool.
Yuck. No eat egg. Brog like rocks.
Let's take the brew eggs. You can take all of them and it doesn't matter. We're gonna do something with them though. It's gonna be interesting. So let's go ahead and go back upstairs. And if you look in the corner here, you'll see this pot that you can actually set on fire with the torch.
Brog like wood, no talk, much better.
And you can put the eggs in the water. And if you sit here and wait long enough, you'll see what happens. Oh my god.
A hard-boiled brew egg? Am I enabling something here?
It turned gold. And you can do that for all of them. You don't have to do it for all of them, but why not, right? You can't have brews hatching and eating us
this
alive.
This seems somehow metaphorical.
Another one. It's the best part.
Do you have some kind of plan here that you might fill me in on? Or were you just suddenly craving eggs?
Sort of kind of craving eggs. All right.
You know, I wonder how old Mother Grew is going to feel about us frying up little Junior here.
Mother Grew's not gonna know, so you just shut your mouth, okay? Alright, so now what we're gonna do is we're gonna take our newly hard-boiled eggs here, and we're gonna use them as projectiles in the general direction over here. And that will open up a pathway for
Brog
us.
Brog do good.
It's almost fun in a way, isn't it? All this jumping business when you get the hang of it. I'm not even thinking about the cruise. Oh dear, cruise.
Brog found Skull. Now Brog need to get Skull.
Alright, how are we gonna solve this puzzle?
Brog no good, but Brog trying. Brog get it. Just need time.
So you can sit here all day trying to solve this puzzle, but when in fact, we have a better solution. See this board? We're just gonna break
Brog
the fucking
much
thing.
Better at this game.
There you go. See? Simple enough. And then we'll take the
Good
skull.
Good puzzle. Smart Brog.
Mm-hmm. That's a nice little exit for us. And we found ourselves a second
Brog
magical item.
Nice home for Skull. Go to sleep, little Skull.
Alright. Now, time tunnel. There's one other thing we gotta do after we watch this little movie here.
Good evening, Grand Inquisitor.
They're rioting in the streets, you know. There's even talk of a magic rebellion. Those imbeciles. If only they knew how much I care.
You ever tried just talking to them?
Everything's so messed up. I mean, that's not even the worst of it. I just killed my college roommate. Or at least I thought I did, but apparently some idiot is carting him around the underground in a magic lamp. If my men don't find him soon, they could ruin everything.
Come on now. Don't cry, Mr. Inquisitor.
Yannick, please.
Yannick, you think you got it bad? I let the love of my life slip through my fingers over a stupid game of strip through fire and water.
Well, at least you had one.
Never even knew her name. I'm gonna be crying too. Look, I wasn't gonna say this, but if I tell you where you can find that idiot and the lamp guy, would that make you feel any better?
Jack, would you?
Two words, time tunnels. Didn't you ever see The Great Underground Adventure 3? Pull yourself together, man. This is embarrassing.
Of course. Yeah. I'm sorry.
Now, come on. Where's that tyrannical madman? Hmm? Do the face.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. Give me that mean face. Now, where were we?
Guards.
Yes, sir.
Bring in the Froboz Electric Hungus Prop.
Right, let's go.
You pathetic fool.
That's my guy!
Hungus Prop.